We got ourselves a monster card coming up on May 1st live on pay-per-view. It's going to be headlined by Andy Ruiz taking on Chris Arreola. But this man, Javier Molina, he is going to be taking on Jesus Ramos. And Javier, I am looking forward to it. This is a stacked card. You're right before Cinco de Mayo. You guys, you got to be pumped to be on something this stacked up for the hardcore boxing fan to check out.
Yeah, definitely, man. Every time there's fights right there at the Dignity Health Sports Park now, there's always fireworks. So definitely excited to start off the night, the pay-per-view card, and to see the main event. I know both of them, Andy Ruiz and Arreola. So, I mean, expect fireworks that night.
Yeah, it's a really cool thing and a great event that they put together, man. So just how are you at this point, just in the point of camp? You're about, 10 days out now. Like, do you wind down? Is there one final tune-up? Like, where are you at as a veteran of the sport? Where are you at this stage of camp?
Yeah, I mean, we're already almost closing the camp off. I had my last sparring on Friday. I just finished sparring right now, just a few minutes ago. I'm right here outside of the gym. But yeah, next week, I mean, just tone it down. My weight's good already. I'm fighting this one at 147, so weight's no issue. So, I mean, just get all the kinks out next week and then put on a show on Saturday night.
You're taking on a very young individual who people think of highly in the sport. What do you think getting ready for this has he not seen that you're going to be able to bring to the table because you have much more experience under your belt?
Yeah, most definitely. Look, he's a good fighter. But he's never faced anybody in my class. He has a good record. He's done what he's supposed to do with the guys he's faced. But I think he's gonna see a lot of different things in that when he's in the ring with me. He said he's been sparring some elite fighters, but it's completely different sparring than an actual fight. But I think we've seen a few of his fights. I think we're gonna be able to expose a lot of his mistakes, and I'm excited to showcase my talent.
You know, you've been a great fighter for such a long time. You're an Olympian. You came up in a family of boxing. But do you remember that, they talk about like in the NBA, like this welcome to the NBA moment. Was there like a time, Javier, where you had like a welcome to pro boxing moment? You were just like, oh, my God, this is completely different. I have to find a different level to dig down and get through this. And you knew that you weren't steamrolling folks anymore. Like you had to get to dig a little deeper and find another level in yourself.
Yeah, well, actually, I made it harder for myself coming up, starting off my career. I wasn't the most disciplined fighter, you would say, coming up. So I wasn't taking a lot of these fights too serious. So even when I had my first defeat, I went in there way too confident. I barely even trained. I remember when I was sparring, I was exhausted by like the fourth round. It was an eight or ten round fight. But when I went in there, the guy went in there longer than I expected, and I ended up getting tired. But I think my career panned out different, but I mean, I take fully blame, but I'm here now. I mean, I had a tough loss in my last fight. So this is one of the fights the type of fight I was looking forward to. Thanks to everybody that made this happen. I'm getting this opportunity to be able to redeem myself, if you want to say. Like I said, I had a good little streak going. I had a four or five fight win streak since the loss to Jamal James. But I mean, unfortunately I had a bad loss against Pedraza in my last fight, but I mean, it's all a learning experience. He's a veteran in the game. He was a two-time world champ. And he took advantage of a lot of my mistakes that night. But I'm here. I mean, just been getting better in the gym and excited to show the world, what I've been doing.
Now, like I said, you were an Olympian back in 2008. We have some guys down here locally. They wanted to train for the Olympics down here in Miami. And pandemic kind of diverted it. Some guys decided to go pro and some decided to continue to pursue because the games got moved. How did you like that experience? Like, what do you think that did, for your career, getting that opportunity? Because, like I said, some decided to go pro and divert off and start getting paid to fight, and some still wanted that prestige of being an Olympian and representing your country. So what did that mean to you, and why do you think it was beneficial for your career?
Yeah, well, being an Olympian, I mean – that was my goal since I was a little kid. When I was in the gym, I was in the same gym as, I don't know if you know, Francisco Bojado, Panchito Bojado. He was on the 2000 Olympic team for Mexico. So when he went, I mean, ever since I was a little kid, I wanted to be an Olympian. And I was the youngest member on the 2008 Olympic team. I was 17 when I qualified. I beat Danny Garcia in the Olympic trials in the finals to make the USA team. I mean, it's something I'm never going to forget. Even walking out in the opening ceremony with all the elite the everybody from the U.S. I walked out with Kobe Bryant, Dwayne Wade, with all of them. I mean, And with all the elite athletes, we're staying in the Olympic Village. Everything in there is free. We're staying with there, all the athletes from around the world. And I was only 18 at the time when the Olympics. But I mean, it's something I'm never gonna forget. But as far as with my career, I feel like I was so young, and that's the only time they did that where all the Olympians had to stay in Colorado Springs for the whole year. So I stayed out there, and then a lot of times I was out there partying instead of focusing on what I had to do. And I mean, it showed. I think starting off my career, that's why, like I said, my pro career didn't pan out the way it should. But I'm here now. I'm 31 years old. I've got a good 5 years left in me, and take full advantage of these opportunities that come to me.
They always say, yeah, is that so? That Olympic Village, that thing's wild. Like, is it as wild as they say it is when you're, especially when you're done with your event? Like, I gotta imagine it gets people are really cutting loose with as much as you guys train for that.
Really, it is. It's crazy though, because they have every building for all the athletes, and then you can see, like, when in the beginning with the opening ceremony, I mean, everybody's like so, like, focused on their events, and once the events start, some sports, they start finishing, you can just see the difference and just the vibes. But I mean, everything in there's free. I mean, you got McDonald's that's free, you got Snickers. I would get my backpack and I'll fill them up with chicken nuggets, Snickers, Powerades, and I'll go outside and take it to my family. Like, man, I was taking full advantage of everything. I think I gained like 20 pounds after I lost.
That's awesome.
Everything in there free, man. You got everything. That's all they, man.
Did you get to hobnob with like any of the NBA stars? Like, did you get to see, meet, or have any interaction with a guy like a Kobe Bryant or Dwayne Wade, who's beloved down here?
Yeah, we actually took pictures with them, but they were the only ones. They went for a little bit to the Village, but they were the only ones that didn't let us stay in the Village, I guess, because everybody was, like, trying to take pictures with them. They didn't let them rest, so they were staying in another. They're the only athletes out of all the Olympians that had to stay in another building outside of the Village. They wanted to stay, but what I did, I got to take pictures with Chris Paul, with Kobe Bryant, with Dwayne Wade. I got to take pictures with all of them. I mean, it was a cool experience, something I'm never going to forget. I was only 18 years old, and being around all these elite athletes, they actually, even when we were training in the boxing gym, Dwight Howard and Kobe Bryant went to the boxing gym where we were training at, and they started training a little bit.
That's pretty cool.
But it was pretty surreal.
Are you an NBA fan? Like, did that like mean something to you, seeing a guy like Kobe?
Oh, yeah, for sure, man. I'm a Kobe Bryant fan. Everybody, even Dwight Howard, like, even the way he was with us, I would see him, I was like, man, and then I remember I ran into him at the food court, and he seen me, he's like, hey, what's up? And I turned around, like, what are you talking to me? But then I was like, oh, like, what's up? He was like, he was real cool. But so it was just, I mean, something like that. That's why I went back home, like, hey, Dwight Howard said what's up to me.
So Javier, like, bro, you're 31, man. Like, this is not you got plenty of boxing that's still in front of you. So what do you think a win this week against the guy who's, you know, you know what it is, like, this is the young gun. They're highly touted, but if you know show them what's what, and you show them that, listen, you still have a long way to come, young fellow. What do you think a win will do for you? Like, what do you want this to launch into for the rest of your career?
I mean, obviously, it's a big step forward. I'm willing to fight anybody at 147, 140 pounds, or so whatever the next move they want to make. I'm willing to take any of those fights. Like, I'm 31. I've been in this game for a long time, since I was 19 years old in the pro ranks, and I started fighting since I was 7-8 years old. So this is my life. This is what I've been doing. But I'm willing to face anybody. This isn't the first time I've been in this position where they have me as a B-side. Actually, my last four fights, counting this, was I'm B-side. Even when I went there with Okada, I was a B-side, and I got him out of the first round. When I fought Amir Imam, I was a B-side. I beat him, unanimous decision. So, I mean, this is the first time I've been in this position, but it doesn't change anything. I'm in the gym just focusing on what I have to do and take care of business on Saturday.
Well, check him out. May 1st. It's a hell of a card. You guys can check out Javier Molina taking on Jesus Ramos. You also got yourself Andrew Ruiz. He is taking on Chris Arreola in the main event. It's a stack card that Fox PBC is putting on. Go buy the fight. Javier, thanks for the time, man. Really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.